السلام عليكم. This is Fatar Rahman Rashid, Assistant Professor of Obstetric and Gynecology, Najran University. Welcome to my YouTube channels. This is the second lecture about MR Suji percentage. I divide this lecture about two parts. This is the first part. Let us to start our lecture. First, we start with obstetric hemorrhage. Antepartum hemorrhage. Antepartum hemorrhage complicates 3 to 5% of pregnancy. Up to 1/5 of very preterm babies are born in association with antepartum hemorrhage. Classification of antepartum hemorrhage. Minor hemorrhage, it is mean blood loss less than 50 ml. A major hemorrhage, the blood loss between 50 to 1000 ml and no sign of clinical shock. Massive hemorrhage, it means blood loss greater than 1000 or with or an or sign of clinical shock. 4.4, the incidence of recurrent abruption. Abruption is recur in 19 to 25% of women who have two previous pregnancies complicated by abruption. Certain miscarriage increase the risk of placental abruption from 1 to 1.4%. Now look for about the previous cesarean section with antepartum hemorrhage. What previous cesarean section, LOR is 2.2. Two previous cesarean section, LOR is 4.1. Three previous cesarean section, OR 22.4. Approximately 70% of cases of placental abruption occur in low risk pregnancies. Placenta previa and placenta previa accreta and vasa previa. Incidence 1 per 2000 to 6000. This is the incidence of placenta previa and placenta previa accreta and vasa previa. The mortality rate up to 60%. Woman with 1, 2, or 3 or more previous cesarean delivery experience 1%, 1.7 or 2.8 risk respectively of placental previa subsequent pregnancy. What is the incidence of placenta accreta? Placenta accreta occur in 11 to 14% of women with placenta previa and 1 prior cesarean delivery and in 23 to 40% of women with placenta previa and 2 brief scar. It is mean it is 1 previous delivery by cesarean section is the incidence of accreta is 23 to 40% and in 2 previa with 2 previous cesarean section is 23 to 40%. In women with placenta previa and 5 or more prior cesarean delivery, the incidence of placenta accreta is up to 67%. Antenatal diagnosis improves the survival rate up to 97%. And in the second trimester transvaginal ultrasound, we reclassify 26 to 60% of cases where the abdominal scan diagnosis a low-lying placenta and 46-47 meaning few women will need follow-up. As fetal blood 80 to 1000 per kilogram, it requires rapid delivery and suggests an aggressive neonatal resuscitation including neonatal blood transfusion. A number of cesarean section related to the placenta previa and hysterectomy. If there is zero number of cesarean section, no cesarean section, the chance of placenta accreta If there is case of placenta previa, 3%, and hysterectomy is about 40.65%. In one previous scar, the chance of placenta previa accreta in placenta previa 11%, and hysterectomy 0.42%. In two, the chance of accreta in if the placenta previa 40%, and in three, the chance of placenta accreta in placenta previa 61%, and number of four cesarean section 67%, and in five 67%. Prevention and management of postpartum hemorrhage. Postpartum hemorrhage can be minor if blood loss from 500 to 1000 or major more than 1000. Major subdivide into moderate and severe. Moderate if blood loss between 1000 and 2000 ml and severe more than 2000. The main therapeutic goals of the treatment of massive blood loss as maintaining hemoglobin more than 80, platelet count greater than 50, prothrombin times and activated partial thromboblastin times less than 15 ml normal, fibrinogen greater than 2 gram per liter, intraoperative cell values, the relative reduction of blood transfusion of 38% and absolute risk of reduction of 21%. Maternal collapse in pregnancy and preparing amniotic fluid embolism. The incidence is between 1.5 per 100,000 and 12.5 per 100,000 maternity, with the most recent UK data giving the incidence of 2 per 100 maternities. Survival rate seem to have improved significantly over time, from 14 in 1979 to around 30% in 2005 and 80% in 2010. Prenatal mortality rate in case of amniotic fluid embolism is 135 per 1000 total births. The incidence of lactic shock between 3 and 10 per 1000, with the mortality rate of around 1%. VBAC 27 to 25 chance of successful VBAC. This is the success rate of VBAC. Success rate of VBAC in twins pregnancy 45 to 84%. Planned VBAC success rate of for preterm and term pregnancy were similar. Previous uterine rupture high risk 5% or higher of recurrent uterine rupture. Planned VBAC associated with approximately 1 in 200.5% risk of uterine rupture. Virtually avoid the risk of uterine rupture. Actual risk is extremely low, less than 0.02%. Two previous scar cesarean deliveries who are considering VBAC should be consulted about the success rate. 71.1%. The uterine rupture rate increase 1.36%. The comparable maternal mortality to the repeat cesarean delivery option. The rate of hysterectomy 56 per 10,000 compared with 19 per 10,000, and the rate of blood transfusion 1.9% compared with 1.21%. As to up to 10% of women scheduled from elective cesarean section go into labor before 39+0 day. Risk of maternal death with planned VBAC of 4 per 10,000 and with the elective cesarean section of 13 per 10,000. Risk of transient respiratory morbidity of 2 to 3% is planned VBAC and with elective of 4 to 5%. Increased risk of maternal mortality with elective cesarean section compared with planned VBAC 13 per 100,000 versus 4 100,000. Unsuccessful compared with successful VBAC increased the risk of uterine rupture 2.3 versus 0.1%. Hysterectomy 0.5% versus 0.1%. Transfusion 3.2% versus 1.2%, and endometritis 7.7% versus 1.2%. This is comparison between unsuccessful VBAC and VBAC. Induced labor, no previous vaginal delivery, PMI greater than 30, and previous cesarean section for labor dystocia, successful VBAC is achieved in 40% of cases. Previous vaginal delivery associated with a planned VBAC success rate of 85 to 90%. Successful VBAC with the previous cesarean section for fetal malpresentation about 84% compared with women with the previous cesarean section for either labor dystocia 64% or fetal distress 73% indication. Success rate for VBAC in prior cesarean delivery due to unsuccessful instrumental delivery was 61.3%. Abnormal CTG is the most consistent finding in the uterine rupture and is present in 66 to 76% of this area. Late intrauterine fetal death and stillbirth. Incidence of stillbirth is common, 1 per 200. Risk of DIC, 10% in 4 weeks after IUFD death. Cesarean section, nice guideline. Discuss potential serious risk. Emergency hysterectomy, 7 to 8 women in every 1,000 uncommon. Need for further surgery at a later date, including curettage, 5 women in every 1,000, this uncommon. Admission to intensive care unit, highly depending on reason for cesarean section, 9 women every 1,000, this is uncommon. Thrombolic disease, 4 to 16 women in every 10,000, this rare. Bladder injury, 1 woman in every 1,000, this rare. Urethric injury, this woman in every 3 women in every 10,000 rare. Test approximately 1 woman in every 12,000, very rare. Discuss frequent risk. Persistent wound and abdominal discomfort is the first few months. In the first few months after the surgery, 9 women in every 100, this is common. Increased risk of repeat cesarean section when vaginal delivery attempted in subsequent pregnancy, 1 woman in every 4, this is very common. Readmission to hospital, 5 women in every 10 women, common. Hemorrhage, 5 women in every 1,000, uncommon. Infection, 6 women in every 100, common. Laceration, 1 to 2 babies in every 100, it is common. Ectopic pregnancy and miscarriage, December 2012, nice guideline. Approximately 20% of pregnancy miscarry. This is the incidence of miscarriage, about 20%. The rate of ectopic pregnancy is 11 per 1,000 pregnancy. About 1/3 of women with ectopic pregnancy will have no non-risk factors. Diagnosis and management of ectopic pregnancy. This is green top guideline. This is the recent one. The incidence of ectopic pregnancy in women attending early pregnancy unit is 2 to 3%. Transvaginal ultrasound has reported sensitivity at 7 to 19% and is specified of 94% to 99%. 0.9 for the diagnosis of ectopic. So it's a diagnostic tool for ectopic pregnancy. A empty intrauterine gestational sac will be present in around 20 to 4% of cases. In up to 20% of cases, a collection of fluid may be seen within the uterine cavity, classically referred to pseudosac. Ectogenic fluid has been reported in 28 to 56% of ectopic pregnancies, and cervical pregnancies are rare, accounting for less than 1% of all ectopic pregnancies. The prevalence of cesarean scar pregnancy estimated up to be approximately 1 in 2,000 pregnancies. 30% of reported cases of cesarean scar pregnancy were misdiagnosed as intrauterine or cervical pregnancy at presentation. Coronal pregnancy is the rarest form of ectopic pregnancy, with the reported incidence of 1 in 76,000 pregnancies. Cumulative ongoing pregnancy rate was 60.7% after salvingectomy and 56.2% after salvingectomy. Persistent trophoblasts occur more frequently in the salvingectomy group, 7% versus less than 1%. Repeat ectopic pregnancy occur in 8% in the salvingectomy groups and 5% in salvingectomy groups. Studies reported persistent trophoblast rate of 3.9 to 11% after salvingectomy. Overall success rate of single dose methotrexate for tubal ectopic pregnancy range from 65 to 95% within 3 to 27% of women require a second dose. Multiple pregnancies. NICE guideline inform women with twins pregnancy that about 60% of twins pregnancy result in spontaneous pairs before 37 weeks, and inform women with triplet pregnancy that about 75% of triplet pregnancy result in spontaneous pair before 35 weeks. Operative vaginal delivery. In UK, 11.8% of vaginal delivery are forceps and ventouse, 10 to 13%. Incidence vary widely between countries, 1.5 to 26%. Investigation and management of small gestation for gestational age. 50 to 70% of small gestational fetus are constitutionally small, with fetal growth appropriate for maternal site anesthesia. Shoulder dystocia, incidence between 0.58% to 0.7%. Increased maternal mortality, postpartum hemorrhage 11%, third and fourth degree tear 3.8%, brachial plexus injury, one of the most common fetal complications, between 2.3 to 16%. 46% associated with substandard care, and 4% occur after cesarean section. Conventional risk factor predict only 16% of spontaneous delivery that shoulder dystocia that result in infant morbidity. Infant of diabetic mother 2.4-fold increase the risk of shoulder dystocia compared to same birth weight for infant born to non-diabetic mother. MacRobert maneuver success rate high as 90%. Internal maneuver or all four position or four technique 83% success rate. The management of third and fourth degree perineal tear. Overall incidence in the UK is 2.9, with the incidence of 6.1 in prime gravida compared with 1.7 in multi-barus ladies. Women should be advised that 60 to 80% of women are asymptomatic 12 months following the delivery and external unexpected bill. There was no systematic review or randomized control trial to suggest that the best method of delivery of following OSIS. The risk of sustaining a further third or fourth degree tears after subsequent delivery is 5 to 7%. The risk of subsequent vaginal delivery after the third degree tear have been assessed with 17% of women developing worsening fecal symptom after second vaginal delivery. The prevention of early onset neonatal group B streptococcal disease incidence in UK 0.5 per 1,000. The likelihood of carriage in subsequent pregnancy is 38% and the neonatal risk is 0.9 versus 0.5 per 1,000. 2 to 3 cases per 1,000 pairs is detected in the current pregnancy. Incidence of early onset neonatal group B streptococcal in UK 0.5 per 1,000. Mortality in UK 10.6 overall, 18.3 less than 37 weeks of gestation, 22% less than 35 weeks of gestation, 5.7% more than 37 weeks of gestation, 80% effective of antibiotic in prophylaxis in prevention of early onset neonatal group B streptococcus, low intrapartum antibiotic prophylaxis. Management of sickle cell disease in pregnancy. Sickle cell disease is the most common inherited condition in the world. 300 infants born with sickle cell disease in UK, 100 to 200 pregnancy in women with sickle cell disease. Acute painful crisis during pregnancy, most common complication in pregnancy, 27 to 50%. Acute chest syndrome, 7 to 20% of pregnancy. Management of diabetes. Approximately 700,000 women give birth in England and Wales each year, and up to 5% of these women have either pre-existing diabetes or gestational diabetes. Of women who have diabetes during pregnancy, it is estimated that approximately 87.5% have GDM may or may not resolve after pregnancy. 7.5% have type 2 diabetes, 5% have type 2 diabetes. Epilepsy guideline. Prevalence of epilepsy is about 0.5 to 1%. About 1/3 of the WWE are the reproductive age groups. The risk of death is increased tenfold in pregnancy with WWE compared with those without condition. 40 maternal deaths that occurred between 2009 and 2012 were attributed to epilepsy in the 2014 MBBRACE UK. 12 of these 14 deaths were classified as sudden deaths, sudden unexpected deaths in epilepsy. Most common major congenital malformation associated with anticonvulsion drugs are sodium valproate 10.7, loperamide therapy 16.8, in mother without epilepsy, the risk is 2.3. The EURAB study data from suggests that the lowest rate of malformation were observed in Zoman exposure to less than 300 mg per day of lamotrigine and less to the 400 mg per day of carbamazepine. The rate of major congenital malformation ZK and Erlang registered were also lower in the liver teams monotherapy groups 0.7 than the polytherapy groups 5.6%. The risk of recurrence for major congenital malformation was increased 16.8% in women with epilepsy WWE with previous child with major congenital malformation. The majority of women, 67%, does not experience a seizure in pregnancy. In women who were seizure free for at least 9 months to 1 year prior to pregnancy, 74% to 92% continued to be seizure free in pregnancy. Pregnant women with idiopathic generalized epilepsy were more likely to remain seizure free, 74% than those with focal epilepsy. Tonic-clonic seizure occur in about 22% of women with epilepsy in labor and within 24 hours of delivery in further 1-2%. Rate of postpartum depression are higher in women with epilepsy than women without epilepsy, 29% versus 11% in control. Management of inherited bleeding disorder in pregnancy, hemophilia. Up to 50% of neonatal males with severe hemophilia have no previous family history. In this case, there is a 90% chance that the woman is carrier, the mother is a carrier with the risk to the next male child. Factor X1 deficiency. Factor 11. The incidence is the non-Jewish population is 1 per 1,000. It is common in the Ashkenazi choice with the heterogeneity in 80% and homozygosity in 0.2 to 0.5%. Obstetric cholestasis 0 to 7% in UK. 0.1 to 1.5 Indian and Asian and Pakistan Asian origin, 2.4 in child population. Pruritus in pregnancy common affect 23% of pregnancy. The incidence of premature pairs, especially iatrogenic, is increased 7 to 25%. High recurrent rate 45 to 90%. Thank you. This is the end of the first lecture about the MRCG percent. Thank you.